So far we discussed about how we can be calculating the speed reduction ratio, psi value, and how to construct the ray diagram, and as well as how to construct the kinematic arrangement. So far we discussed it. Now we want to discuss about how to calculating the number of teeth with the help of the two things like ray diagram as well as the kinematic arrangements. Now you carefully understand, previously you noted the letters like A, B, C, D, whatever it is. Now you can represent 1, 2. Then only we can choose the number of speeds, which one is the maximum, which one is the minimum. Okay, so now we focus on stage 1, because stage 1 becomes 1 input to minimum speed and maximum speed. So it will be marked as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So out of 3 to 2 is equal to 6 speeds we can attain. Now we go with another one, this point. So what is XML? 6 is last digit. You start with 7, 8, again 9, 10. So again, last with 10, you start with 11. 11, this is 12, this is 13, this is 14. So now our minimum speed is equal to N12. N12 is a 160. And our maximum speed become 1600. Okay, now you can consider, carefully understand. First we have in a 60. So I like this, Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z3 plus Z4 is equal to Z5 plus Z6. This is my combinations. So number of teeth is equal to Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5 and Z6. Now we focus 135. You should come here up 135. So it is a single point. So this is the speed is equal to 1600. So you can write it, rearranging these things. N1 is equal to N3 is equal to N5 is equal to N1, N3, N5 is equal to directly 1600. Okay. Parallelly 297. 297 is equal to N2 is equal to N7 is equal to N9 is equal to this point as well as N14 is equal to 630 RPM. Now we focus on 8, 11, 13. N8 is equal to N11 is equal to N13 is equal to 400. And in between points, 4. N4 is equal to N4, N10 is equal to 800. N6 is equal to 1000. And N12 is equal to 160 RPM. So now you can change the N1 to N12 values based on this relationship. Now you can check it. N1, N3, N5. N1, N3, N5 is equal to 1600. Now you can focus on N7, N9. N7, N9 with attachment of 2. So N2, N7, N9, N14. 14 is in first pair. Is equal to 400. 11 and 30. 11 and 30 with the help of 8 is equal to 400. So we can verify with those things. So this is our stage 1. Stage 2 becomes Z7 plus Z8 is equal to Z9 plus Z10. This is our stage 2. Last one, Z11 plus Z12 is equal to Z13 plus Z14. This is our stage 3. Now we want to calculate these things with the help of
reduction ratio.
Now you consider above cases, Z1 plus Z2. Always assuming the minimum value. You always assuming this value is equal to 20. It is always assumed. Why we can assume? I will tell you later. Okay. Initial stage, the minimum value Z1, Z7, Z11, the three values should be taken as assumption as an 20. Now you can equate in this and finally you got 1 divided by N2 is equal to Z2 divided by Z1. It is the cross multiplication. Like suffix 1 here, suffix 1. 2 is the sense 2. So N1 is equal to 1600. N2 is equal to 630. We don't know the Z2 value, so it is unknown term. Z1 value we can take it as 20. So finally Z2 is equal to 1600 divided by 630. So this is 2.538. So it goes there. So it is multiplication. So into 20. 50.79. Our Z2. Now we are adding both these cases. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to 20 plus 50.79 is equal to 70.79. This is our total value. Okay, now we can calculate in the Z1 plus Z2 combination. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to 70.79. Now we can evaluate, check with another combinations. So both things, either Z3 plus Z4 is equal to got same answer, or until Z5 plus Z6 is equal to got in the same answer. We can verify it. Any doubt in this regards? Can I erase like this? Okay, I can do here. Some space is there. Now you consider Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z3 plus Z4. Now you forget about this. Parallel you can do this kind of relationship. So N3 divided by N4 is equal to Z4 divided by Z3. So it is a suffixes you can mention here, cross multiplications. So N3 is equal to, you know, 1600. N4 value is equal to 800 in terms of Z4 divided by Z3. The two things we don't know the values.
1600 divided by 800.
So Z3 is equal to Z4 is equal to 2 of Z3. This is your equation 1. Now you can substituting the equation to this, finally you got the answer. I can use here. So now you go with the Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z3 plus 2 of Z3. Okay. Now you should already be solving this value. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to 70.79 is equal to 3Z3. I'm right. Now Z3 is equal to
70.79.
So Z3 is equal to 23.60. Z3 is equal to. Now you multiply with the 2 into Z3. So Z4 becomes, you are substituting here the value.
Answer into 2.
47.19. Now we are adding this Z3 plus Z4 is equal to plus 23.60. So exactly 70.79. Now you can verify the second combination also, we got it. Parallelly, we calculating the final peaks. I can do here. So now the last combination, Z5 plus Z6. So Z5, N5 divided by N6 equal to Z6 divided by Z5. N6 value becomes, N6 value already we know, N5, 1600 divided by N6 is equal to 1000, is equal to Z6 divided by Z5.
1600 divided by 1000 is equal to 1.6.
So now you take it as an, now you take it as which one? Z6 is equal to 1.5 is equal to 1.6 of Z6. So I consider this as an equation 1. You substituting this combination, Z1 plus Z2 combinations, you substituting this combinations, you got the results. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z5 plus Z6. Either you make it as Z3 or Z4, whatever it is, because both the values are same. So Z3 plus Z4 is equal to 70.79 is equal to Z5 this is Z6 is equal to so Z5 is equal to 1.6 plus 1.6 plus Z6 plus Z6. Now 17.79 is equal to 2.6 of Z6. So Z6 become 35.395. Now you substituting this value in terms of Z5. So Z5 is equal to
into 1.6,
56.632. Now we add in the Z5 Z6. Now we add in Z5 and Z6, it becomes
27,
not 35. Now you can check it. I am considering this as a Z, so it will be little bit confused. So Z6 value 27.23. So substituting the here, Z5 becomes
into 1.6,
43.56. Now we add in this 17.70. So this is our Z5 plus Z6. So now our first equation, whether the verified Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z3 plus Z6 is equal to Z5 Z6. So this is our problem. Okay. Now we go with the second relationship. So this becomes value 70.79. Okay. Now you took the second stage of equation, Z7 plus Z8 is equal to Z9 plus Z10. First we check this. So this is assumption as 20. So then N7 divided by N8 is equal to Z8 divided by Z7. N7 value we know. 630 divided by N8, 400 is equal to, Z8 is unknown value, Z7 is equal to 20. So Z8 becomes 31.5. This is our Z8. Now we are adding Z7 plus Z8. Z7 plus Z8 is equal to 31.5 plus 20. So 51.5. Now you compare it. Stage 1, it is greater speed, 730 to 51. So greater to lower. Okay. Now you integrating this second combination also. Z7 plus Z8 is equal to Z9 plus Z10. We do this. N9 divided by N10 is equal to Z10 divided by Z9. Am I right? So N9 is equal to 630 and N10 is equal to 800. So we don't know the Z10 as well as Z9. So 630 divided by 800, it is the Z10 is equal to 0.7875 of Z9. The equation 1 should be equating with this relationship. Now you can check it. Z7 plus Z8 is equal to 51.5. N7, N8 is equal to Z8 divided by Z7. N7 is equal to 630 divided by N8 is equal to 400 into 20. 51.5. This is value is equal to 51.5. We can use 50 or 51. Okay, 51.5. Now you are equating this. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to 51.5 is equal to Z9 is equal to Z9 plus 0.7875 of Z10. So Z9. So 51.5 is equal to 1.7875 of Z9. Z9 becomes 51.5 into it. 1.7875 of Z9 is equal to 28.81. Now we substituting the value to Z10. So in multiplication with 0.7875. So our Z10 value becomes 22.69. So you are adding the both things plus 28.81. So Z9 plus Z10 is equal to 51.5. So Z7 plus Z8 is equal to Z9 plus Z2 is equal to 0.75. Our second stage, Z7 plus Z8 is equal to Z9 plus Z10 is equal to 51.5. Now you compare, this is greater, this is smaller. Now you are calculating this also, it will be a lower. So it will be a greater, this will be a lower. Compare with the kinematic arrangements. Greater to lower, greater to lower. So our calculation and as well as number of things is equal to right. Any doubt in this regards? Thank you guys.